If you want to learn how to measure and plot temperatures, build wireless radio controllers, use servos to drive tools, or build weird things like, I don't know, a thermal camera, here, you'll learn mechatronics in minutes. Okay, let's take a break from learning and build something useful. If you're a DIYer, chances are you have a 3D printer. When generating the G-code, most slicers will tell you the quantity of filament, but how do you know if your spool has enough? Today, we'll build a filament meter. Mine is called the Filameter. It's pretty straightforward and works by an infrared sensor monitoring passing filament. Let's get started. The parts list is pretty basic. A nano, a dip socket, a 1.8-inch LCD display, a pulse sensor, a push button, a buzzer, a bicycle wheel type bearing, some wire, an encoder pickup, and of course a 3D printed case. If you have never wired up an LCD display, here's how using this SPI based unit. It has an ST7735 display driver, and there are libraries readily available. First, connect the display's ground to ground, VCC to 5 volts, SCL, which may be called SCK on some displays, to pin 13, SDA, which may be called MOSI on some displays, to pin 11, RES to pin 8, DC to pin 9, CS to pin 10, and BL can be left unconnected. You may have to connect it to VCC though. Connecting the pulse sensor is as follows. Connect the sensor's ground to ground, VCC to 5 volts, and the DO to pin 3. A push button is used to let me reset a new roller and is simply connected to ground and pin 2. A cheap buzzer will get connected to ground and pin 6. Note that the sound will be controlled by a PWM frequency, and very few pins on the Nano support PWM generation. Pin 6 just happens to be one of them. We'll power the Nano with an old phone charger. Like I said, let's keep this thing cheap. I wanted my case to be as small as possible and bolt to the top of the printer. That way I can still print tall parts and have good path from the roller to the extruder. The PCB board is an odd shape, but that's to let all the guts fit in and around it. The sensor will be hot glued into place. The sensor pickup has 10 notches. I tried 20 for greater feed distance resolution, but that caused some misfires. Here, one revolution is 10 centimeters, and that's close enough. A groove is cut into the roller to keep the filament centered. Some guide pins are added to keep the filament between the bearing and the pickup. I created a drawing so I can inspect the critical dimensions, namely the pinch distance between the bearing and the sensor pickup. All looks well, so it's off to the printer. I sure hope I have enough filament. I have no idea. At least not yet. Normally, I print my own PCB boards, but a project this simple, we'll just wire it up using the schematic as a guide. I use dip sockets in all my projects, so if I accidentally brick the MCU, I can just plug in a new one. My wiring job is not the neatest, but it gets the job done. I did use two types of wires. Solid for the fixed components and flexible stranded for the button and sensor. The PCB board is an odd shape, but since I designed it relative to the other components, it's guaranteed to fit into the case. Speaking of an assembled unit, here it is. Now it's time for some coding. As with any project, first include the libraries. A display library for sure, but I'm also storing the remaining filament quantity in non-volatile memory so I can have available quantities shown the next time I start a print. That's what the EEPROM.h is for. I have my own color definition file, but it's nothing more than a bunch of defines an appropriate hex value. If you know me, I refuse to use the basic fonts. I'm using just two custom fonts that came with the Adafruit Underbar GXF library. Thanks for all your hard work, Limor Fried, who is the founder of Adafruit. Flickering screen updates drives me crazy, so the flicker-free print library only updates changed data. A bunch of variables and object initialization. I have three objects for flicker-free printing: quantity remaining, quantity used, and for the fun of it, cost of the current print job. In setup, we'll use standard pin modes to define some of our pin functions. I also have my own getParameters function for getting the stored remaining quantity. Note, depending on your display, I did have to adjust the Adafruit underbar ST7735.cpp code. For some reason, the green tab identifier produces wrong colors, and the working black identifier had a display margin issue. Just change the CPP file and around line 240 and 241, Add the following. Initialize the display and optionally set the SPI speed. I'm not sure it really matters, but I did it for fun anyway. I have included a cute little beep beep sound to let me know when the unit is ready to go. Display the header and data. I use functions for this so I can update the screen at will, namely when I post a message on the screen. I'm not using interrupts for monitoring sensor pickup. There are just too many bounce issues and I didn't feel like addressing them. This program is very small and simple, so simple polling is used. Here I have a test for determining if the spool is less than some threshold. I save the remaining length every meter. That way, there's no manual intervention to save the data. To minimize bounce issues, I first start tracking the sensor when it's low, then when the signal goes high. If it's in that order, it must be a legitimate pulse. This is probably more complicated than it needs to be, but remember, the roller is spinning very slowly, and plastic fragments on the notches may cause a misfire. I accommodate three button cases. If you press the button just one time, it will save the remainder to the EEPROM. If you press and hold the button, it will reset the system to a brand new roller. If your filament gets below the threshold, an alarm will sound. Pressing the button will cancel the alarm and reset the threshold to 1 meter less. The rest is simple display code. And here is the unit in action. Notice how the remaining filament is counted down, the used quantity is increased, and the current print job's cost is displayed. As the filament gets consumed, the sensor pickup rotates, firing a pulse on each notch. See the filament holes and guides to keep the filament in the tracking groove. Press and hold to load a new roll. I recommend doing this before you feed the filament, that way you can get an accurate distance count. If you hit the minimum threshold, an alarm will sound and a button press will shut it up. Not too difficult of a project, but covers tons of areas such as mechanical design, software design, and electronics, hence mechatronics in minutes. Well, that covers this week's lesson. If you learned something, give me a thumbs up. If you have a tip to share, leave a comment so my subs can learn more. Thanks for watching.